Ever heard about the Green Children of Woolpit? These two siblings showed up in England in the 12th century. In fact, they were discovered by locals close to the pits that gave the town its name. They spoke fluently in a language that was never deciphered. Their clothes were noted as being odd in appearance, and above all this, their skin was green. Where the children came from remained a mystery until the sister was in adulthood and had learned to speak English. She described coming from a place called St. Martin's Land, a world inhabited by green people. She is quoted as saying, "We are inhabitants of the land of St. Martin, who is regarded with particular veneration in the country which gave us birth." Being further asked where that land was and how they arrived at the village, she answered, "I'm ignorant of both those circumstances. I only remember that on a certain day, when my brother and I were feeding our father's flocks in the fields, we heard a great sound, such as we are now accustomed to hear at St. Edmund's, when the bells are chiming. And whilst listening to the sound in admiration, we saw land across the way, a cave close by the water. We went into the cave and found ourselves among you in the fields where you were reaping." Being questioned whether that land they believed in Christ or whether the sun arose, she replied that the country was Christian and possessed churches, but said the sun does not rise upon our countrymen. Our land is little cheered by its beams. We are contented with that twilight which, among you, precedes the sunrise or follows the sunset. She probably answered the Christian part of that question very wisely. This was a period when she could have been tried as a witch in England, but you have to wonder if the two children may have experienced an interdimensional slip, much like the man from Towrid's story and many other people who appeared to literally pop up at locations on this planet, apparently speaking unknown languages and confused as to how they got there. This incident is not a one-off, but one of very many. In a 1996 article published in the magazine Analog, astronomer Duncan Lunan hypothesized that the children were accidentally transported to Woolpit from their home planet, which may have been trapped in synchronous orbit around its sun, presenting the condition for life only in a narrow twilight zone between a fiercely hot surface and a frozen dark side. It is possible, in theory, that portals to alternate dimensions exist all over the Earth. It could only take the correct magnetic pulse, as well as the effect of the moon and correct weather conditions, to pass through one of these portals and reach an alternate dimension. This story has enthralled the imagination of the curious mind through the centuries. There are many suggestions. This was a tale of folklore, or the children were immigrants, and even inspired by the story The Babes in the Wood, where they were poisoned and left to die in the woods by their wicked uncle. Whatever the answer is to this story, whatever the reason for their appearance may be, it has continued to captivate us for centuries. What do you guys think of the Green Children? Comments below, and thank you for watching.